Thank you for joining me. This is going to be a tutorial on pancakes with syrup as a charm size. This is bigger than the 12th scale size. I showed 12th scale in the nail tutorial. So what I did here was I took some clay. I'll show you the actual mix. This larger amount here is Primo Translucent. There's a little bit of Primo Ecru, and then this is white. That's about the right mix. And this is what the finished clay color looks like, just a warmer version of white. I'm rolling them in little balls. It's a little bit less than half an inch. I'm filming on a different camera today to see if this one is any better. You guys will have to let me know if you prefer this. It just seems like I can't come up close without it getting out of focus. The other camera focuses better close, so you'll have to let me know what you prefer. So from here, I have three balls that I flattened. What I'm going to do is make some pastel dust with my blade. So I'm going to do some yellow ochre here. Here's some rust. And here is a little bit of brown. I'm going to give myself a little bit more yellow ochre. There we go. And I am going to dip my brush in the yellow and paint the top yellow. I'm trying to keep it off of the sides because pancakes often have a lighter side than top. Not in all cases, but most cases you'll notice that pancakes are lighter on the sides. And one of these little pancakes will be on bottom. So I would flip one of them over. And if that's going to be your bottom pancake, go ahead and put a little bit of the yellow ochre on the bottom side of that one too. And then you could take a little bit of rust and add rust in to give it more of a baked sort of a look. I'm going to do that to all of them. The color is pretty poor lighting in here right now. But it is simple, so I wanted to show you. And then with the smaller brush, I add just a little bit of brown towards the edges on just a couple edges, not a whole lot. And the trick with pancakes is trying to get the top looking realistic enough and baked without being too dark, because if you get too dark, it's harder for the syrup to stand out. I'm going to texture the sides. So from here, I just use a toothbrush and roll it. So we do that with all three. And then I do a little bit around the edges of the bottom and the middle pancake. And on the top, I'd put a few more in, but pancakes aren't really holy, so for the top pancake, I'll kind of brush it around the surface as well as do a few dots, but I'll brush it around the surface and that helps kind of soften it, kind of like the cheesecake that we did. And then for the top pancake, I might come back and add a little bit more color just in case the brush took any of it off, the toothbrush. I am going to take a toothpick, dip it in some TLS, put it on top of the bottom pancake and the middle pancake. This acts as a glue. And then I start stacking the pancakes. I usually offset them just a little bit from each other so it's not a perfect stack. Now the butter is actually yellow, white, and translucent. It's pretty much the same mixture here, but you're using yellow instead of the ecru, so it's a lot more white than yellow and a lot more translucent than anything else. You want at least half translucent. So once you have that, you can take a small slice and cut yourself out a square. I would press the square between my fingers just a little, just that way I soften the edges so the edges aren't too hard. Then from here, I may put a tiny bit of TLS on the butter and then place it down onto the pancake wherever you want the butter. Press it down, and now we're going to make the syrup. I'm going to move this paper forward just a little bit so we're a little closer to the syrup. Now, for the syrup for the charm size ones, because Fimo is so thin, I just use TLS alone. I'm going to use spiced, it's a spiced pumpkin color of food coloring. It's just kind of a rich orangey rust color with some sparkle to it. I mix that in. And then I'm going to dip my wet toothpick in just a little bit of a dark bronzy copper color just to add a little bit of brown to it so it's not quite so orange. Golden colors look nice too, but you do want to have a little bit of a touch of brown if you put like a gold color in. And in case you guys missed seeing me paint the pancake in the nail tutorial, because I got out of frame somehow. Usually at this point I put my pancake stack into my baking tray. And I start painting on the syrup. I start with putting some on the paper. It would actually be your baking tray next to the pancake to help it stick down a little bit as you're continuing to paint. But I spread it out over, making sure you leave some of your pancake showing. Just have it drip down wherever you want. If you have it baking on a baking sheet, like a non-stick baking sheet, or baking tray, then when you pull it off, you have the nice flat pool of syrup on the bottom. If you cook it on paper, it may rip a layer of paper, and you'll be able to see that under the syrup, which isn't pretty. So bake it on either your metal non-stick or your glass baking tray. And you just decide how you want the syrup pattern. But as you can see, there is still pancake showing. This is a nice, rich, dark maple brown color of syrup. You'd bake it at this point. Since I'm showing you how to make it a charm, you could either stick a safety pin through it when it's all done, like I showed in the video how I make my food into jewelry, or before you cook it, right now, once it's in the baking pin, you could take your head pin. The head pin, the nail side is here. The pokey end is here. I would just decide where I want the top of the charm to be and poke straight through And you would cook it just like this. Once it's done, you finish poking it all the way through, and then you could take the head pin out and pop it back through the right way. Let's see if you could see this. Let's see if it focuses. The bottom of my head pin is here, and the top comes out the side. And all you do is put a gloss glaze on your syrup to make it nice and wet looking. I use triple thick. Triple thick has some substance. So a cheater way of doing syrup, if you want, it dries kind of flat, so you may have to do it twice if you do it this cheater way. But you could take the triple thick, and you could actually mix the food coloring into the triple thick, and once it's fully mixed, you could use a toothpick to paint on all the drips. So if you do have only Fimo Deco Gel, and you are using that, and it's really pale along the sides where it's dripping, you could take the triple thick and put a little coloring on it to help disguise and turn it darker. That's just a hint, just in case you put your syrup on without baking it. I really do like to do a test run where I mix my mix, and then I cook it for 18 minutes, just to see if the syrup's the right color, and then I'll do a whole batch of pancakes with the right syrup color to keep from wasting. So that's just it for today. I'll be doing eggs and bacon soon. If you have any particular breakfast foods that you could think of that you'd really, really like to see, please request them. I plan on doing some waffles, the eggs with bacon, perhaps eggs Benedict, or biscuits and gravy. Just feel free to let me know what type of things you're wanting to see. I'll try to fit in whatever I can over the next 2 weeks. Thank you so much for joining me, and let me know if you prefer a video off of this camera. This is the first time I've done this particular camera. Or if you prefer my cell phone, which is what I normally do it off of. It looks to me like, for distance-wise, this is okay, but whenever I come up close, it seems like it has a hard time focusing with this camera, where the cell phone, at least, you can see up close really well, but my voice is really quiet on that one. We'll see how the voice goes here. Thank you so much. Bye.